my friends, without further ado, let's move on to the situation along the front line, starting immediately with the Kherson direction. Here we are observing maximum activation from the Russians. They have initiated assaults not only in the area of the village of Kyiv, but also near Bohdanivka and on the islands around Gola Pristan. Clearly, in three directions simultaneously, they are attempting to improve their positions and push the Ukrainian armed forces out from the left bank. Despite ongoing shelling on the right bank and around the city of Kherson, there are no changes along the front line in the past day. Intense battles persist. In the midst of this, the Ukrainian armed forces have given the Russian artillery a black day.
According to the situation in the evening of January 1, 24 in the area of the village of Krynki, today was a black day for our artillery in the Dnipro main army. The enemy carried out a massive drone attack on the locations of our long-range artillery, which was withdrawn from the Dnieper by about +20 km, beyond the area of the Alyoshkinsky sands. The number of disabled artillery systems is approaching almost 24, and this is already a division.
According to the information coming from the Russians, it's evident that the Ukrainian armed forces are clearly executing a plan to eliminate the Kherson-Crimea grouping of Russians and have precise intentions to expand their footholds and advance toward Crimea. So, we await positive news. In the Zaporizhzhia direction, the occupiers continue to suffer losses in the vicinity of Robotyne. They still struggle to make significant advances along the front line, but the attacks persist practically every day. Today is no exception. They are storming the positions of the Ukrainian armed forces near Robotyne and shelling along the entire front line. In the Vuhledar direction, shelling continues along the entire front line, and the Russians have also begun to advance towards Urozhaine. However, the Russian attacks were unsuccessful, as in all other directions. So the front line remains unchanged, and the destruction of the occupiers continues. In the Avdiivka direction, there is a significant intensification of Russian activity. Following yesterday's, one might say, lull, attacks are ongoing in the Novobakhmutivka and Stepove areas. Several groups are simultaneously storming the coke chemical plant and attempting to approach the outskirts of the city. The battles are intense, so we are awaiting the results. Additionally, attacks from the eastern side on Avdiivka itself have resumed. Here, the occupiers are trying to break into the city along the outermost street. Battles near the industrial zone persist, but they are changing the direction of attacks, moving closer to the railway today. On the southern flank, battles continue for Pervomaiske, and fights are underway in the Neversk area. The front line remains unchanged for the day. Southward, in the Marinka area, there is a high number of shelling. The occupiers are trying to destroy the positions of the Ukrainian armed forces to break through to Georgievka. In the Novomikhailivka area, attacks have also ceased. The Ukrainian armed forces have successfully held their defense, and today there is a significant amount of shelling. In the Bakhmut direction, the occupiers failed to advance in Bohdanivka. All previous attacks were unsuccessful, and today only shelling continues. However, to the south, in the Klushivka and Avdiivka areas, battles persist, accompanied by shelling of Ukrainian armed forces' positions in the devastated villages. The Russians haven't achieved success over the day, so the front line remains unchanged. In the Siversk direction, the occupiers continue shelling, but their quantity is minimal and no offensive actions are reported. There are no changes along the front line. In the Crimea area, the occupiers were unable to break through to the village of Makiivka. Today, all attacks have ceased and only shelling of the villages of Terny and Nevsky continues. But the front line remains unchanged. In the Svatova area, the number of shelling has decreased again and no attacks are reported. Therefore, the front line remains unchanged with no significant activity. In the Kupiansk direction, there is a renewed activation. Yesterday, there were 11 attacks, and today there are reports of 7 attacks in the Sinkivka area, with battles starting near the highway. So we are waiting to see the outcome of the new Russian attacks. But for now, there are no changes along the front line for the day. And today, foreign publications analyzing the situation predict that winning the war will not be possible in 2024. Plans are in place to develop a new mechanism of assistance for this year.
Ukraine will not be able to win in 2024. As there is neither manpower nor weapons for a breakthrough, The Times, citing British intelligence. The publication writes that the UK and other EU countries are working on a mechanism to ensure that they can help Ukraine win the war without the help of the United States. British ministers are trying to ramp up production capacity across the continent to send weapons to Ukraine and deter Russia for at least another year.
Overall, we wait to see how events will unfold for them. Unfortunately, the loner the war continues, the stronger the Russians consolidate their positions. They show no signs of stopping and continue to increase their production of weapons and ammunition. In a New Year's interview with The Economist, Zelensky stated,
"Europe don't speak about support to Ukraine. You support yourself. Giving us money or giving us weapon, you support yourself. Ukrainians are fighting for the world. That is the answer what the world has to focus and recognize."
Many people outside Ukraine are saying, maybe it is time to negotiate with Putin. Maybe it is time to start talking. Can you tell me categorically whether that is an option for you in 2024 or not?
That is not the moment of discussion, of compromises or not compromises, because we don't have any fundamental steps forward to the peace from Russia. We have to speak with Russians, not attack us. Anytime Russia can attack you, you have to be ready. Why I have such reaction? Because all their steps mean another thing. When they have discussion on conference of Putin, he said, no, we didn't get all the results. We will go forward. What does it mean? That we have to sit and say, sorry, please stop, or something like this? It's not our position, this weakness. And he feel it like animal, because he is animal, and like feeling of the blood. And that's why he will feel his strongness and he will eat you. Totally.
A quite powerful statement. It is also reported that there are no longer specific terms for the deoccupation of territories. But according to Zelensky's statement, it will happen eventually.
A few more theses of Zelensky from an interview with The Economist. Orange Circle Ukraine's main military goal in 2024 is the isolation of Crimea. Orange Circle Taurus missiles could allow Ukraine to destroy the Kerch Bridge at the cost of. Orange Circle mobilization concerns all of us.
Also, today in Kyiv, the falling debris of rockets was recorded in several areas. According to preliminary data, there are impacts on the territory of a civilian infrastructure object in the Podil district. And in some parts of the city, there are disruptions in electricity and water supply, and there are also reports of 20 injured. Meanwhile, Putin started this year with threats against the West.
Несмотря на то, что они испокон веков ставят такую задачу разобраться с Россией, мы сами быстрее с ними разберемся, похоже.
And that's all for me. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay updated on all the latest news. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye-bye.